Hace muchos años, esta vela bendijo a nuestra familia con un milagro. Nuestra casa, nuestra casita, se llenó de magia.
First of all, this has been my favorite movie this year. It's amazing. I can get the songs out of my head. It's incredible. Thank you so much for this movie.
Oh, that's so nice to hear.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a huge surprise. So my first question is, this type of movies, animated movies, take a long time to of production, and things usually change during this time. Were you sure of who each member of the Madrigal family were going to be, and what their gifts were going to be, or did someone change hugely during this time?
There was definitely changes over time. I mean, I think the biggest one that comes to mind immediately was we thought initially that Julieta, Mirabel's mom, would be the one who would have this kind of like emotional weather power, but then we realized that that meant that she could never really be emotional in the film. And so we switched it around, and then once we realized that making Julieta this healer who healed through food felt really a lot like a lot of the moms that we had known in terms of being nurturing. So that was one of the biggest ones that changed, but there were certainly others as well.
Yeah, and everyone has an aunt that is a little bit, yeah.
We all know who she is.
So, Charisse, speaking about powers, I also wanted to ask you about if it was difficult to stick the magic of the movie between the sort of rules of magical realism.
Mm-hmm. So I think, yes, we were definitely really inspired by magical realism for this film. And I think that meant that we had to kind of come up with a sort of working idea of what that meant for us in this film. And I think what Jared and I landed on as we were writing the movie was that the magic in this film was born out of character, relationship, emotion, instead of being something that was sort of foisted upon them. I think my favorite example of it is the moment where Abuela Alma is in this terrible moment of crisis, and just her desire to protect her family and this unconditional love is what creates the entire Encanto. And so I think all of the magic in this movie, we tried to think of it in terms of that, you know? Even when we were giving the characters different gifts, they were all based on different family roles, you know? Luisa, as the strongest, most responsible person in the family, is the strongest person in the family. And so it was all, these choices were all made really coming out of character and emotion and sort of relationship.
Jared Byron, I wanted to ask you about the music numbers in the movie, and specifically the decision about making some of them with that music video aesthetic. Was it difficult to reach that decision, or did you want it to explore like outside the boundaries of the Encanto world?
We knew that this movie is going to take place in the house, that the, you know, usually our movies are journey movies or a quest, and two characters go off into the world and they go to these other lands. But we knew we have 12 main characters that live in this house, and we want to spend time with them. That meant everything's in the walls of this house, but we don't want to feel confined. So actually from the beginning, we knew that we would use these musical numbers to really expand, you know, visually what's happening. The music of Colombia is unbelievable. There are so many different styles of music. And we, in this movie, wanted to feel like something as current as a reggaeton that you hear in Luis's song. And then, you know, a song like Dos Oruguitas, which feels like it's a folk song from 100 years ago. And then you have Isabella's song, which is really sort of a rock and espanol type of song. We wanted to have all of those and not feel bound to the time period of our movie or the confines of the house. And so that was a really fun exercise. It took a lot of work to figure out how to tell a story and have music at the same time, meaning visually what is happening. Luisa's song is a great example of that. What is Mirabel learning over the course of the song? So it's not just a song, story is happening at the same time. But really we wanted to get a sense of who these characters are, and Lin-Manuel did such a great job of taking a musical style combining that with a personality type, and then our artists and our amazing animators were able to create these huge numbers with crazy choreography that really sort of explode over the course of the movie. And yeah, it's something, it was always our dream to do something like that. I think what the teams were able to do beyond our wildest dreams, for sure.
Yeah, and did you get to use every song Lin-Manuel composed, or was there anyone that got scrapped?
No, it's, you know, amazingly, none, usually that happens. Usually we do scrap a song and we don't use it. You know, but honestly, every song that's in there, Lin wrote. We know, I guess the toughest one for us all to figure out was Mirabel's song, Waiting on a Miracle. That was the last one to land and figure out. I think because we needed the whole film to be in place, and we as filmmakers, or as directors, we needed to see the end of the film to see where Mirabel wound up with Abuela and the family and who she was before we knew exactly what that song needed to be. So Lin was great. He really rolled with it, and he did several versions of that song to really find her. And what we wound up with was incredible. And also, it was recorded at an incredible moment because Stephanie Beatriz, the voice in the American version, was 8 9/10 months pregnant. Like, she was very, very pregnant. She was about to have her baby, I believe, right? She recorded that song, and 1 week later, she gave birth her first child. So it was incredible. It was, so Lin says she recorded "Waiting on a Miracle" while she was waiting on a miracle. It was just amazing. But no, again, to compliment what Jared was saying, Lin was able to give us this full spectrum of beautiful songs that feel timeless and contemporary and moving and energetic, and such a surprise for a Disney musical. So he really knocked it out of the park. He really did a great job.
Yeah. I can't get them out of my head. It's amazing. It's in every one of them. This is Disney Animation's 60th movie, and animation has got to a point that it's simply incredible what it can do. It's almost difficult to find what is the next step in each movie. What is the milestone that you wanted to achieve in this film? Because I saw in some of the music numbers, the camera movements are incredible. The texture of the clothes are. I don't know how you do it. It's amazing.
We don't either.
Amazing. No, I know. I think it's because, you know, Jared and I always say, I will put Charisse in this category, but we always say we're surrounded by people who are way smarter than us, because Charisse is smarter than us. So it's like that, you know, but I think we're surrounded by geniuses at the studio who really, really know what they're doing. And they grow every time they're asked to step up to a new level on the film. Just like you said, on this film, the choreography, the cinematography on the camera, the moving cameras, the focal length on the lenses, the beautiful animation on the cloth and the hair. And sometimes, you know, it's funny because I didn't know this was missing until someone showed me, but there's a new technology with the eyes that we tried on this film, where our VFX supervisor at the beginning of the film, when we were deciding what the characters looked like, he came in and he said, this is what our eyes look like now on Disney characters like Frozen and Tangled and Moana. Here's what they did look like. Here's what they could look like. And he clicked a button and the Encanto eyes popped in. And it's a new eye shader that behaves just like your real eye, like reflects, and there's a depth and you can kind of see into the character's soul. And I was like, we were like, holy smokes, we have to use that. And we fully embraced that. And for this movie, especially when you have so much subtle acting when you're up close, it's so important to really connect. So I think it'll be like that for the next 20 years. Like, there will be these things you didn't know was missing from animation that comes in and you go, I don't know how this is hitting that level. But again, geniuses in the studio, we have so much respect for everyone around us, and they keep surprising us. It's awesome.
Yep.
Thank you again for this wonderful interview, and thank you for this this movie. I hope it goes well.
Thank you so much. Great talking to you.
Mágico, yo también soy igual de especial que el resto de mi familia.
¿Quién quiere más rosa?
Oigan, chicos, ¿dónde tiro la carreta?
Tal vez tu don es vivir en negación.
Encanto, encanto.